traveling salesman problem, or TSP, is a classic computer science problem that was first defined by William Hamilton in the 1800s. Its focus is to find the shortest route between any number of cities. But what is it exactly, and how do we solve this problem? Well, let's say you're a door-to-door salesman who wants to visit 50 cities around the United States. How would you determine the order in which you visited these cities? Well, you could simply calculate the distance of every possible route and compare them to each other, right? Well, this is called the brute force method, and it sounds like it could really work. Luckily, I have a program here that could tell me how long it would take to compute the answer. Let's see here. We want to visit 50 cities, and let's say we can calculate each route in 1/100th of a second. That seems about right. So, what are we looking at here? 15, 20 minutes? That's the number of years it would take to calculate every possible route. To put that number in perspective, that's more than the current age of the universe. By a lot. Now, I know what you're thinking, but that's horrible. How can that be right? Well, because there are 50 cities to visit, that means that there are 50 factorial, or this many, possible routes to compare. So, what do we do? We don't have that kind of time, and we've got to get out there and sell some doors. Well, when classic methods like brute force are too slow, we can turn to a heuristic. These are techniques designed to find a decent solution in a much shorter amount of time. Let's see some examples. First, we'll look at the greedy heuristic. The concept behind greedy is simple. The city you visit next is the closest unvisited city to where you currently are. The algorithm then stops when you get back to your starting city. For example, let's say these items represent cities. And our starting point is this big rock. From here, the closest point is the washing machine. The closest city to the washing machine we haven't visited yet is the cart. We continue this process until there are no cities we haven't visited. Then we go from the last city on our trip back to our starting city. And now we have our route. As you can probably tell, this is not the best route we could have taken. But it's likely better than what we could have gotten from guessing at random, and it's a lot faster than the brute force method. Next, we'll look at the two-opt heuristic. This algorithm is defined by rearranging two edges, or paths between cities, at a time to create a shorter overall route. Let's look at a different map. Here, we have six rocks of various colors connected with logs. Can you find two edges that can be rearranged? That's right! The edge between the brown rock and the clear rock has 10 logs, and the edge between the white and red has 6. These edges also do not have a rock in common. Let's see what this route looks like after we've rearranged the edges. That's much better. Our new edges are from the brown rock to the white rock, which has 3 logs, and from the red rock to the clear rock, which has 5. Rearranging these edges made our route a total of 8 logs shorter. There are no more edges in this map that we can rearrange to make our route any shorter. You'll typically find more edges to rearrange in maps with a higher number of rocks. So that's it. We've solved the traveling salesman problem. We can all go home now because our work here is done, right? Well, it's worth mentioning that there is currently no perfect heuristic. And by that, I mean there is no one algorithm that has proven to be the best in every situation. In fact, given the right circumstances, the solution they provide might not be very good, and in some other cases, they may not present a solution at all. However, without these heuristics, we would have to wait a very long time in order to find an answer. Thank you for watching, and have a great winter break.